Welcome back. Thanks so much for joining us. We have in the studio Jim Baumgartner, and Jim Baumgartner has started a daily program. It's called the Weekly Daily Program with Jim Baumgartner, the Weekly Daily Show.
Don't forget Alicia.
And Alicia.
Yeah.
But we never see Alicia.
Because she's the crew. It's like we don't have all the nighttime, we've got to be a little bit more clever because, well, we don't have this entire incredible ensemble of cast and crew.
Why, what if you would, you know, like pay your dues, you know, to the union.
Oh,
that,
you know, the union. See, I'm not exactly anti-union, but at the same time, I've heard they cause problems. So saw a guy with a limp once because of a union, but that's a whole different story. So hi, Dan, how are you?
Hey, doing just fine.
Welcome to the show.
Tell people a little bit about you. Huh?
Oh.
He's like taking over.
You're not going to be asking questions about me.
Oh. Well, I'll just provide the answers. Be ready, everybody.
There you go. I've been in that situation where people provide answers about me.
Oh, well.
Yeah. Then you get in trouble doing that.
Yeah,
so tell us about. Let's get on track here, boys. Weekly Daily Show. What is that?
The Weekly Daily Show is a nightly adventure into the fun and merriment that you can find in Harrison and the surrounding area. For the most part, we try to keep everything light and fun and update folks on things from the goings-on at the Boone County Library to the Harrison CBB, the downtown We Love Harrison folks. And they've been doing so much down there and really trying to really rejuvenate downtown and just the work that's being done, the rebirth of the HHBA and all these other things. Historic Harrison Business Association. So we're Rick Schoenberger, get t-shirts, people need those. And a lot of us, but then also the platform itself has opened itself up to discussion of other things that aren't necessarily so, you know, sweet and lovey-dovey all the time.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because again, some things just have to be talked about, mainly just for the sake of clarification, because one of the things that in my career here in Harrison that I certainly pride myself on is if there's a rumor that comes out, I want to get it busted or verified, one of the two, either way it goes. And that can get a little dicey sometimes.
Where there was speculation, you're going to address it head on.
Yeah, exactly. And hopefully we actually get to the root of what is happening. Sometimes it kind of still stays to the left or the right because some folks still don't want to talk, which is terribly unfortunate because in our modern world of how we're all interconnected and instant information, commenting is the most important thing anyone can ever do to clear the air, because if not, the trolls, it's so important.
Yeah, freedom of speech is one of our inalienable rights as an American, but you walk a thin line between opinion without facts or the actual person that knows something to voice their opinion.
Yes.
And that's where you get into trouble with today's social media and the way society thinks nowadays. Everyone knows the answer, but they really don't know the facts to base an opinion on.
Exactly. And then you'll get that one little sliver from someone, and that passion and that emotion will get attached to it, and then people will jump on the passion and emotion bandwagon, and things can get out of control.
And that
really
becomes
quick.
Their truth, which is not really the truth.
And it can be so terribly, terribly unfortunate. But you know what? That's really not what it's all about, because it is about informing and connecting the community. Because, again, an informed community is a connected community.
Mm-hmm.
And knocking down a whole lot of walls and barriers in that realm. And it's one of those things. You just got to be willing to take the swings, and I'll take them.
I think one thing that has bothered me is as I get a little older and have connection with, you know, the earlier times and watching news reporting is that the facts are not really the main important thing of a story anymore.
No, not even
it's,
close.
It's opinion, speculation.
What is going to keep the viewer in tow and in turn the advertiser? And that's the reality of it. CNN, Fox, MSNBC, CNBC, if they have initials and they're out there, that's their goal. It's a business, period, end of statement. We're a business too, and that's very, very much true, because you got to have something to pay for all these incredible lights and cameras and everything.
Yeah.
But you can still maintain your integrity. The way that for many years now, I've always tried to handle everything when it comes to being as objective as possible, is I'll set the camera up and let it roll on something, and then put it out there for the world to see, unedited. Form your own opinion at that point with what is presented. Mm-hmm. Now, if you don't want to take the time, then it's your own fault. It's just like voting. If you're not willing to go register, go vote, don't shut up. You know, well, don't go complaining after Election Day. Matter of fact, that's another thing that's actually launching today, or in the process of launching, is the Weekly Daily Show with Jim and Alicia is going to be doing a big Register to Vote campaign to get everybody here in Harrison, Boone County, Baxter, Newton, Marion, Searcy, everybody to get out there, get registered to vote, get to know your candidates, and we're working on all of that stuff right now.
Mm-hmm. And I'll be the first to say that sometimes these elections come and go, and I'm not informed enough.
Well, we're going to fix that this year.
Yeah.
Well, you have to figure for the past, just about the whole 10 years I've been here, as it's came about, I made it a point to make election information and coverage kind of a priority as they come along, because I've been providing live election coverage just about every election cycle for the past 10 years in one form or another. And that's not going away anytime soon. So we're going to do it again this year. But this year is going to be bigger and better because we got the Boone County Election Center talking with Crystal Gretti Monday. And so we're meeting next week to actually put together a really good who, what, when, where, why, and how the whole process works. And I'll be rolling that out in the coming weeks. Again, it's just one of those things that the community wants it. They don't realize exactly how much they need it until after the fact.
Sure,
But again, we've been doing this, Alicia and I, we've been doing it for a long, long time now, it seems. So it's we're not going to stop now.
So what if somebody has an interesting topic they'd like to, let you know about?
Dan, this is where the Weekly Daily Show services you so easily. I am here. Okay. So, number one, you can private message us on Facebook, or you can call here to the station, 741-4891, and you can remember that number because another great, great, great aspect of the show, and thanks to Dan Reynolds willing to dig around and crawl around through the rafters and everything else, we have a phone line that we take calls. Mm-hmm. So if we can't get you booked, because we actually are filling up fast, man. It's like the whole week is booked, next week is booked. It's just boom, boom, boom. Guests are not a problem. Mm-hmm. But you can call in. So when I say call in, you can do that. And when you do that, guess what? You can get the word out. And we're very, very proud of the fact that our average viewership per night is about 1,000 folks. So that's our average. Now, we've seen some that have spiked up to like 9,000, depending on the topic. And again, that's where everybody loves controversy, and those will just go through the roof.
It's usually controversy that does that.
Yeah, but at the same time, though, it's like it's going and it's growing. And a big shout out to our first three sponsors that we have: Crossroads Medical Clinic, El Mexico Lindo, the absolute best Mexican food in town. And also Liquidation Outlet. I've been doing all kinds of fun video stuff with them for years because they're helping us to grow. Because the way it's going right now, actually, the way the guests are coming out, is we're looking to probably expand to 2 hours here in the coming weeks because there's just so much content that's getting thrown at us.
And I wanted to mention that you're not doing this. You're not doing this as a philanthropic endeavor. Though this is something that you want to be able to.
To maintain and
to
sustain.
And for people out there watching.
You see these shoes, people? They are wore out, man.
It's amazing.
I need new ones.
What we can appeal to the audience is, if you can help in any way, is the best thing to do is, if you like what Jim does or you like what we do, is you support the people that are sponsoring the program.
Go say hi.
Right.
Eating it.
El Mexico Lindo, best chili rellenos on the planet.
Or, servicing some of the, or visiting some of the sponsors that are helping you.
Absolutely. Right. Go just say, I saw your spot. We appreciate that. Because it does mean a lot.
It goes a long way.
It really, really does. And so, and let them know what you like about it. It's like the Express Liquor Spot. I love that spot. I absolutely love that commercial that you guys have where the dude stops the shoplifter cold.
Mm-hmm.
Literally with a right hook. It's great. Yeah. If you haven't watched it, stick around. It'll be on in a minute. So
right. We do have Eric here too.
Hey, look at that.
We do have a last guest that we want to get in, and let's tell people where the show is, where it's at, and the times that it will be airing.
Very, very simple. You can't miss us. We are live every night on Facebook. Go look for Jim Baumgartner because we're working around Facebook's pickiness. Go to my personal page, but then we share it over to the Hometown Television, the Weekly Daily Show page, also the Little Birdie pages. We're all over the place. Okay. And then you can wake up in the morning at 8 o'clock following Dale Hoffman's Down the Corner, 8 o'clock every Monday through Friday morning on XL7 and K26 respectively. And it's a whole lot of fun. It's a little condensed because sometimes we run long. But the best thing is like we just roll and we go and it's free flow conversation. Right. It's cool.
Okay.
Thanks, Jim.
All right. Thank you, Jim.
Thank you,
Start
guys.
Watching. We're going to take a quick break, and when we come back, we'll be talking with Eric Stefanski from the Ozark Arts Council. Stay with us.